maths master teacher at Vedantu. So I hope my pirates are doing good and taking care of yourself, right? Aur acche se pad rahe ho, right? So today we are going to boom this whole chapter data handling in one go. So this is the last session for this whole chapter, and in this we are going to revise all the concept, all the things in one go. Ready to boom this? All right. So with the word data, we are going to start it. Do you recall the number of runs you have scored in the last 3 matches? Or do you remember how many marks you have scored in the last 5 matches? Marks, test. Or do you remember what are the places do you have visited in the last 5 years? So these are the nothing but the data. The information collected in all such cases is called data. Data is usually collected in the context of a situation where we want to study. For example, you wanted to study about, or you want to research about the marks you have scored in the last test matches, or you want to know how many marks you have scored in the mentee sessions. So that is nothing but data. Okay, now in order to learn more about data, we are going to first see what are the problems which you face and what are the solution which Vedantu is giving you. So if you want to solve the doubts problem, notes you want, test assignment you want, competitive exam preparation you want, schedule according to your choice, and language according to your choice. So Vedantu have solved all of them in the form of Vedantu Pro Subscription Lite. With this, you are going to get bonus, unlimited live classes, micro crash courses free, performance report, personalized attention will be given to you. So everything you are going to get, visit this link which is given in the description box. Click on that, choose your grade, and you need to select one. We have 3 plans basically, 1 month, 3 months, and 6 months plan. So choose according to your choice and use this link vdnt.in/ytpro. And if you want the discount offer, that is 15% additional discount at the base price, you will get it if you apply the coupon code ATPRO. So guys, data is in the form of organized and raw. But what is raw data? First, usually raw data means data available to us in an unorganized form called rated raw data. To draw meaningful inferences, we need to organize them systematically, which then becomes organized data. So can you see this? We have made down it into the tabular form. Now this data has been converted into an organized data, and that is readable, and we can definitely analyze that. Okay. Now, the distribution obtained is called grouped frequency distribution, or what is known as class interval. That means 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, etc. Upper class limit means 10, lower class limit means 20. The difference between the upper class limit and the lower class limit is known as width or size, or you can say range. Alright, now we are going to see how do we organize the data graphically. First is pictograph. What do we mean by pictograph? When we use some symbol or some picture in the form of making that graph. Sometimes data is represented in pictorial form, or we can get a clear idea what it represents. Pictograph represents the frequency of data while using symbols or images that are relevant to that data. This is one of the simplest way to represent statistical data. So many of my pirates are really, really good in drawing. I hope they are going to love this pictograph, because you are going to represent the data in the form of some symbol or some images. All right. Now, next thing is we are going to represent the data in bar graph, double bar graph, and histogram. They are nothing but you represent the data in rectangular bars. So there are some basic differences when you are going to use bar graph, double bar graph, or histogram. Let's see. Bar graph represents categorical data with rectangular bars with heights and or length proportional to the values they represent. So can you see different heights of these rectangular bars? They represent different values, right? For example, this is the example given to you with a survey of 145 people were taken, that you have to tell which is the nicest fruit according to you. So 35 people say that they like apple, 30 people according to them they were liking oranges, 10 banana, 25 kiwi fruit, and so on. So can you see this rectangular bar? this is going to represent what is the height of this rectangular bar is going to represent what is the data for the likability of fruit apple. So apple is liked by 35, orange is liked by 30 people, this banana is liked by 10 people, and so on. So bar graph can also represent it in this horizontal form. What are the properties? So bar graph have to be in equal width. यार आप ऐसा नहीं कर सकते कि आप अपनी मर्जी से इसको मोटा पतला करो. दैट इफ़ यू लाइक टू मेक ऑरेंजेस बिगर तो आप रेक्टेंगुलर बार ऑरेंज का बड़ा बनाओगे. नहीं, द विथ शुड बी इक्वल फॉर एवरी रेक्टेंगुलर बार. बार्स कैन बी ड्रॉन हॉरिजॉन्टली एज वेल एज वर्टिकली पर एज पर आवर नीड्स. ठीक है, देयर शुड बी इक्वल स्पेसिंग बिटवीन द बार्स. आप इक्वल स्पेसिंग ही रखोगे बार्स के बीच में. और हाइट बताएगी कि डेटा का क्या एग्जैक्टली वैल्यू है, और उसका बेस भी कॉमन होना चाहिए. डबल बार ग्राफ होता है सिमिलरली बार ग्राफ के, बट यहाँ पर आप दो डेटास को एक साथ रिप्रेजेंट करते हो बिकॉज यू वॉन्ट टू compare the data. Okay, so bar graph showing two sets of data simultaneously, it is used for comparison of the data. Now what is histogram? A graphical representation of data in this manner is called histogram. The height of the bars shows frequency of the height interval. Similarly like that, what is the basic difference between bar graph and histogram? That you can see that there's a gap between the rectangular bars, but histogram there is no gap. ठीक है, बिल्कुल सटे हुए होते हैं. अब नेक्स्ट रिप्रेजेंटेशन होता है पाई चार्ट. पाई चार्ट बिल्कुल एक सर्कल के फॉर्म में होता है. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड सर्कल ग्राफ. द ग्राफ री डिवाइड द सर्कुलर स्टैटिस्टिकल ग्राफिक इन टू सेक्टर और स्लाइसेस टू इलस्ट्रेट न्यूमेरिकल problems. Okay, so circle graph is named for its resemblance to pie which has been sliced. There are variations on the way it can be represented. The different slices can have different values of the data. Now what is central angle? Total angle is basically 360, and central angle is the fraction of that 360. मतलब part है पूरे 360 का. ठीक है, अब central angle मतलब part का निकालने के लिए आपको चाहिए formula. तो central angle का formula है value for the component divided by sum of the value of all component, multiply कर दो 360 degree से. तो जैसे कि एक example लेते हैं, that ये activities हैं आपकी जो आप दिन भर में करते हो, sleep, school, play, homework and other. तो sleep में आप 8 hours, school में 6 hours, play में 3 hours, homework में 3 hours, others में 4 hours. तो इसको एक pie chart में convert करने के लिए, first you need to convert the sleep hours into that 8 hours into the angle, the central angle for this. तो अब central angle निकालने के लिए आपको पता होना चाहिए total duration of the hours, वो है 24. तो 8 जो कि है sleep का divide by total into 360, वही आ जाएगा आपका central angle for sleep. And school का आ गया 90, उसी formula से. ऐसे आपने सारे formulas निकाल दिए. Now this is the turn to make the पाई चार्ट. आप एक सर्कल ड्रॉ करो, एंड आफ्टर मेकिंग द सर्कल स्टार्ट मेकिंग द एंगल्स अकॉर्डिंग टू योर चॉइस प्रोटेक्टर की हेल्प से. जो भी एंगल होगा जिस भी एक्टिविटी का, उतने एंगल का डिग्री आप बनाओगे प्रोटेक्टर से. नाउ दिस इज द टर्न फॉर प्रोबेबिलिटी. अब प्रोबेबिलिटी को समझने के लिए ये समझो कि चांसेस क्या होते हैं. अब एक बात बताओ, आप जो सोचो वो ज़रूरी नहीं ना हो जाए, या हो भी जाए. ठीक है, तो जो भी चांसेस है, जैसे आप सोचो कि आपके 5 चैप्टर आ रहे हैं एग्जाम्स में और उनमें से आपने 4 पढ़े और जो छोड़ दिया उसी में से सारे क्वेश्चन आ जाए, या फिर आप सोचो कि अगली बॉल पे आप 6 मारने वाले हो और आपने मार भी दिया तो ये हो भी गया, या फिर आप सोचो कि आप रोज ही लेट जाते हो और बस तो हमेशा ही लेट आती है, तो पर आप किसी दिन जल्दी चले गए और बस जल्दी आ गई, या फिर वाइस वर्सा, कुछ भी हो सकता है, राइट. So it's nothing but probability. Getting a result means when you toss a coin, it can result into head or tail. That you can control. Can you control the outcome? क्या आप control कर सकते हो कि आप head चाहो तो head ही आए, ये tail आपने choose किया तो tail ही आए? नहीं ना, वो तो कुछ भी हो सकता है, right? Random experiment is the experiment, trial, observation that can be represented numerous times under same conditions. That outcome is an individual random experiment, must be independent and identical just identically distributed. We know what is the GIF right now on your screen. This is from the very famous movie Sholay, where they have acted and they have chosen that if they are going to get head, then they are going to go for fight with the goons, right? Now, equally likely outcome, as both outcomes have equal chances to be result, hence we can say that the results can be head or tail, or both outcomes are equal likely to happen. That means if you know that this is a coin, that means there are equal chances that you can get a tail or that head also. Now, likely, liking chances to probability. Consider a coin toss. The outcome are head and tail, and both are equally likely to happen, but the result can only be one. Yeah, result to ek hi aayega na. Chances to dono ke hain. Now, let's say you have called for tails. Hence, your favorable outcome is tails and total outcomes are 2. So, the probability of getting the tail is half. How? So, probability is equal to favorable outcome divided by total outcome. So, what is your favorable outcome? That is 1. That is nothing but tail. That which you have chosen for that. So, 1 out of what? 2. That is why half is the probability. Can you explain about the outcomes and probability of a dice thrown? Explain probability of various numbers. तो आपको पता है एक डाइस में आता है 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. इन नंबर्स के अलावा और कोई नंबर नहीं आता. तो इसमें आपके likely to happen क्या हो सकते हैं outcomes? That आपका अगर एक आए तो एक होगा, 2, 3, 4, 5. तो total outcomes आपके हो गए 6. अब आपको चाहिए मान लो कि 6 आ जाए, तो 6 आने की प्रोबेबिलिटी है 1 डिवाइडेड बाय टोटल आउटकम्स, दैट इज 6. तो यूज अ डाइस थ्रो फॉर लाइव एक्सपेरिमेंट. अभी क्या करो, आप एक लाइव एक्सपेरिमेंट करके देखो खुद से, तो आपको खुद पता चलेगा कि इस 6 के 6 आउटकम्स में से 5 आने की प्रोबेबिलिटी क्या है, या फिर इन 6 के 6 आउटकम्स में 1 आने की प्रोबेबिलिटी क्या है, राइट? नाउ अब आप ये भी समझो कि इलेक्शन के रिजल्ट्स जब आते हैं, तो एग्जिट पोल्स में जब जैसे आप चूज करते हो ना रिजल्ट्स, तो वो इक्वली लाइकली टू हैपन है, या हो भी सकता है, नहीं भी हो सकता है, प्रोबेबिलिटी है वहाँ पर. अब जैसे कि वेदर फॉरकास्ट रिपोर्ट आती हैं, तो वो कैसे आती हैं? आपकी प्रीवियस डेटा के अकॉर्डिंगली, राइट? सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट प्रोबेबिलिटी, एंड वी आर डन फॉर दिस डे, एंड वी आर डन विद दिस होल चैप्टर, एंड वी हैव बूम दिस चैप्टर. कोई डाउट है, डू राइट डाउन इन दी comment section. So guys, in this chapter we have done everything. If you have doubts, jaldi se aa jao telegram pe aur mujhe pooch lo. So guys, these are the problems. We are going to solve all the problems in terms of Vedantu Pro subscription. You are going to get bonus. Visit this link and choose your grade and choose your plan. We have 3 plans, and just visit this link vdnt.in/ytpro and choose the coupon code 80. No. Now this is the time for challenge day. Now this is the question. Find the probability of drawing a card of jack of black color from a fresh deck of 52 cards. So hit the like button, share and subscribe with your friends so that you never ever miss any update. So thank you so much guys. We'll see you in the next session. Bye bye. Bye. Stay care.